Hello, everybody. Hope you're all doing well today. This is exercise 7.7 from KISO. And let's take a look at our first question here. So this is recording bad debts. Duncan Company reports the following financial information before adjustments. So we had accounts receivable at $100,000. They had the allowance for doubtful accounts at $2,000. And they had sales revenue on credit and then sales returns and allowances. Okay, ADA. So the first thing it's asking us to do is to prepare the journal entry to record bad debt expense, assuming that Duncan estimates bad debts at 5% of accounts receivable. So let's go ahead and do this one. So the way I do this is I'm always going to take the balance sheet approach. I will never use a percentage of credit sales. So the allowance had a balance here before any adjustments. So call this pre-adjusted. And it's just kind of a reminder, how do we go through and do this on our balance sheet? So when we're showing accounts receivable on the balance sheet, it's going to be AR less our allowance for doubtful accounts is going to give us accounts receivable net. And the reason why this is so important is that this is the gross amount of receivables less what we do not expect to collect gives us accounts receivable net. And we're taking this balance sheet approach. If I take a look at Facebook, right over here. So if I go to Facebook, I look at their 10Q. And let's see how they're, see how things are going with COVID. So we take over here, accounts receivable net of allowances of $365 million and $206 million as of June 30th and December 31st, 2019. So for Facebook, right, they're going to show accounts receivable net. What that means is that their AR net is right over here. So that's how they're showing it on the balance sheet. So it's less this allowance. And so here, if my accounts receivable net is $7.483 billion. And if I look at over here, if my net, if my allowance is $365 million, so that means the gross amount of my accounts receivable is $7.8 billion. And what's interesting here about Facebook is, wow, okay, so they're actually, their revenues are kind of holding in line, maybe not as much of rapid growth, but they're still doing pretty well. However, what is interesting though, is that they do have a, their allowance for doubtful accounts is almost doubled. So interesting, okay. Let's go ahead then and take a look at this. So we've got here, AR, allowance for doubtful accounts. The first thing we're always going to do is we're either going to be given, there's two different ways you can come up with allowance for doubtful accounts. The first one is going to be a percentage of accounts receivable. The second one is a, as a, based on an aging of accounts receivable. So here it says that five, basically I estimate 5% of accounts receivable. So this here is going to be, my ending balance is going to be 100,000 times 0.05. So this is my ending balance and the allowance for doubtful accounts. Okay. To do the adjustment, and when I'm doing a journal entry to record bad debt expense, my entry is always the same. Over here, this would be 12/31, I don't know, 19 or 12/31/20. I'm going to debit bad debt expense. I'm going to credit the allowance for doubtful accounts. And this is to record bad debt expense. So right over here, my entry for A is going to be $3,000 because that's what I need to do to get from 2 to 5. So I'm debiting this for 3, this over here for 3. So that's part A. Part B is going to assume here that instead of a $2,000 credit balance, we had a $1,500 debit balance. So now my question becomes, what minus 1,500 gives me 5,000? This is going to be 6,500, because 6,500 minus 1,500 is going to give me 5 grand. So the only thing that changes here is that my bad debt expense is now going to be 6,500 instead of the 3,000. So that is exercise 7-7. Uh-oh, what happened to that one? Is there an exercise 7-9? Is there one? Did I miss it? I don't know. We'll see. Okay, so that is exercise 7-7. Thank you for joining me here today, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great one.